potentially dangerous Japanese tsunami debris that's washing up on our coast. Thanks for joining us tonight. I'm David Rose.
And I'm Marnie Hughes. The massive earthquake in March of 2011 that rocked the country also triggered a massive tsunami. More than 28,000 people were killed and entire towns wiped out.
And now debris from that natural disaster is showing up in Alaska, Oregon, and Washington, and it's expected to get much heavier. James Lynch is on Alki Beach tonight. Now, James, we know the debris will be all on the coast. What are the actual chances, though, it will make it there to the sound where you are?
Well, David, one scientist told me earlier today that the chances that tsunami debris will actually make it here into the sound are pretty good, but he said there won't be much. He said for every 1,000 pieces of tsunami debris that comes ashore, only one will actually make it here to the sound. The big problem will be out on the coast. The amount of debris that is expected to come ashore and the damage that it could do is immeasurable. First, there was that 160-foot Japanese fishing vessel, a ghost ship that had to be sunk before it reached land or came in contact with any other vessel. Then, just last week, that Japanese fishing dock in Oregon, 7 feet tall, 19 feet wide, and 66 feet long, and just about every other kind of debris imaginable. And it's only the beginning.
You've seen all the styrofoam that's been washing up. Potentially, it'd be 1,000 times more than that. So beaches might be several feet thick for many miles.
Curtis Ebesmeyer is an oceanographer. He says the bulk of the more than 1.5 million tons of tsunami debris is still months away, and his biggest concern is styrofoam.
The birds like to eat it. It gets in the waves in the surf zone. It gets ground up into food. It goes right into the food chain. So if we don't get the styrofoam right off the beach real fast, it gets ground up and into the food that's in the marine food web.
The worst case scenario is that the beaches become littered with woody debris, plastic debris, large debris, metallic debris.
Giora Proskorowski is a University of Washington oceanographer. He says the other big concern is invasive species. We've seen them on that fishing dock and in the container where that Harley-Davidson motorcycle was found. They could change our ocean waters forever.
There's a natural balance already established, and you introduce one species which can run rampant over, it's not just one species, but over a whole multitude of species, and it distorts the natural balance that's already been established via geography and a natural forcing.
The good news, according to Proskorowski, is that most of the debris will never make it ashore. Instead, it will get caught up in the Pacific subtropical gyre, a large system of rotating ocean currents.
Some of it will get processed, especially the woody debris. But a lot of the more persistent products, the plastics, are going to remain in the subtropical gyre for years and years to come. And that's just, it's going to accumulate along with all the other plastic debris that's already located there.
Now, Ebesmeyer says the states that are going to be most heavily impacted by this debris, including Washington, are not nearly prepared for the cleanup. He said, imagine how many volunteers and how many dumpsters it will take to clean up all of the mess. He expects the bulk of what's coming ashore to be here within the next 3 years, and then he expects it to continue to come ashore in much smaller amounts for the next 60 years. Live on Alki Beach in West Seattle, James Lynch, Q13 Fox News.
On Monday, Governor Chris Gregoire will hold a news conference to talk about how the state will deal with tsunami debris. We'll be there to bring you updates, and we first found out about this debris washing up on our shores through a viewer tip. Now, if you have a story you think we should check out, go to our website, q13fox.com, and click on Send Us Your News Tip.